Hey there, everybody. How you doing? It's me, Waddles. Welcome back to a brand new leg of the Minecraft Guide, episode number 51. It's a big episode. Take a seat. We're entering the second leg out of how many legs? Probably infinity legs of the series. Oh boy, it's gonna be big. You know what? I think we need to commemorate. We need to celebrate this day. Baguette. You know how we could commemorate this day? I was thinking about it, and I remember seeing something over here, and we could celebrate this day this way, and it would be really special, and I'd always remember it. Ah, another parrot. Of course we could use another parrot. Hey, we're best friends. You, take the seeds. Oh, you're a greedy boy. Oh, that's okay. I will name you Mark. Mark is your name. Red Parrot, come back here. Get back here. You live with me now. Mark, you are my best friend. See, I thought a parrot would be the perfect way to celebrate this episode, because, of course, me and the parrots, we have an amazing track record in this world. Absolutely stunning. So, perfect. Brand new parrot. So I've been seeing a comment, a particular comment, quite a few times, many, many times. A few would be a gigantic understatement. I see it every single episode since probably about episode 20 now. Storage building when? Well, guess what? Storage building today. Storage building next episode. Storage building forever. Nope, it is not a troll. It is finally time to break ground on the storage building. Today, we're going to talk all about planning and designing a storage building because, you know, they're kind of such an important build. In the next episode, we will actually build the building. And oh boy, I have some big visions, some big dreams. Hopefully, if I can do this correctly, this will be my best storage building ever and definitely my biggest storage building. Now, why am I looking at this corner of the jungle? Well, of course, that's because that's where I want to put the storage building. I think the storage building would probably fit perfectly, like right over here on the hill, probably like coming out to, you know, kind of what, like where the hill ends. Maybe we pull it forward a little bit. I don't know. It's going to be big. We're going to need a lot of room. But yeah, a gigantic storage building sitting right over here, looking that way towards that, and we'll be able to see it from over there. It'll look cool. We'll be able to see all of that from over here. It's going to be really, really cool, and it's going to be gigantic. In fact, the storage building might end up being part of a gigantic, bigger build. But of course, when you're going into any storage building build, you want to have a plan. If you don't have a plan, it's not going to go well. So let's actually go ahead and jump over to another world. Here we are over in a brand new super flat world. This will be our super flat world for the second part of the series. My take is every single storage building incorporates three big elements. When designing one, you want to consider these things. Element number one, the design of the storage building. Element number two, the organization. And finally, the third element, which definitely goes with the organization part, is the function part. Of course, you're going to want your storage building to be the design that you want. You want it to look good. Should it be a castle? Should it be a spaceship? What do you want? The design, of course. Organization. You want the storage room to be organized in some way. If your storage room is organized, you'll be able to find things quicker. Function. Find things quicker. Yeah, I like that last bit. You definitely want to be able to use your storage building easily, quickly. It should be functional. So, of course, I could just start talking about what you shouldn't do, what you should do, what works, what doesn't work, but what if, maybe, to make things a little bit more spicy, we went on something, kind of like a world tour 2.0. I think that would be a little bit better. So, let's go ahead and jump back in time to some old storage buildings that I built. We'll talk about what worked, what didn't work. Ooh, this first one's a big one. It's an old world. Had to find an old world download, but here we are. Oh, we're actually in the room too. Minecraft Guide Season 1. Oh my gosh, it's been so long. Okay, you know what? We have to do this. Open to land, creative mode. This is a world backup. Anyways, we don't use this world. Look at this world. If you didn't see this series, wow, this is where the guide all got started. Look at the giant villager pyramid over there. The builds over here. And then this is where I went like crazy. Easy mode and just built giant versions of everything. See, there's a chicken, there's a turtle, there's some giant sea pickles over there. That's a sea pickle farm. Yeah, this world was really, really fun. But storage room. So here's the storage building in this world. Now, in terms of organization, the storage room, it was pretty on point. I mean, we have clear sections for everything. When I talk about organization in a storage room, it's of course where you're gonna actually put things. So over here, we have resources. Back in this day, these were all the resources, no netherite included. Over here, we had stone. Over here, we had wood and then some other things. Then earthy blocks over here, like dirt, sand, you know, that type of thing. And then over here on the other side, I had more like mob loot drops, you know, things like that. So the organization was pretty on point in here. This was a pretty easy to use world. And by the way, these smithing tables, these didn't work back then, and they were just like a cool floor. But anyways, organization on point. The problem here, in my opinion, I don't think I ever said this, but the function was honestly kind of annoying in this room. I didn't like it. See, I would go and like, okay, I gotta get some stone. So I come over here and grab the stone. And then I'm like, okay, well, next up, maybe I need some bamboo. So it's a lot of back and forth, right? Like over there, then over here, over there. And I don't really like that. I mean, sometimes, of course, you have to have it. It's inevitable. You can't put all of your chests right next to each other. But this was kind of tedious to use, and it was kind of hard to remember where things were, honestly. Like with some of the basic things, I mean, it's right in front of you, but then having things tucked like way back here, yeah, if I was looking for them, sometimes I'd have to like run around and like look at the chests and be like, okay, where did I put Nautilus shells? Oh yeah, that's right, they were over here. It was kind of annoying to use. And the other big problem here, expansion. If I ever wanted to expand this room, well, good luck. I didn't really have much room for that. I mean, I could put more chests up here, but seriously, that's not much more room at all. If this world were to have lasted any longer at all, I mean, I would have needed to build like a new storage building entirely, because we have these chests right there, couple right there, and then I think maybe two right there. Yeah, then that would be it. The nether update stuff, it definitely wouldn't fit in here. And that's not even thinking about the bee update, like honey and honeycombs too. So organization, it's on point. But function, not exactly. It was kind of hard to use, and it would be really, really difficult to expand. Definitely not a good thing when talking about storage buildings. Alright, so this time we're taking things even farther back, but expansion. Expansion is definitely something that you're going to want to consider when setting up a storage building. If you don't have a storage building that can be expanded easily, well then what's going to happen when you want to keep that world long term and your storage building inevitably gets filled up? Yep, that's right, you're going to have a gigantic, gigantic problem. Now, the next world. Admittedly, I can't remember if there's a storage building in this world. I just kind of wanted to come back to it and check it out. Because, of course, I was in this world for a while, which means there has to be storage somewhere. In some way. I think I had some kind of storage set up over here, maybe maybe it was in this building? No, definitely not. Not in that building. Okay, well, my whole concept with this world was living under the water. So as you can see under here, I did lots and lots of building down here, under the water. So, storage. I have to have things somewhere, right? I swear, I had a storage building. That's a cactus farm. That's a vine farm. This is like a main hall building. With comments, I think, and patrons too. Storage though. Who storage? Okay, did I really come to a... Oh, here it is. Here it is. Here it is. I knew it. The storage building. So this world, this is where things were a whole lot more on point. So check this out. We were living under the water. This is right after 1.13 dropped. I was obsessed with water. Or I think it was around then. I'm not too sure. But the storage room, it was pretty much perfect. I mean, check this out. It's a circular design. I love circular storage buildings because it completely eliminates that whole function problem thing. I mean, you have a circle here. You can stand like pretty much anywhere and find things really, really quickly here. I mean, look, dirt right there, and then I can turn around and run over here and get like prismarine or whatever I needed. Yeah, a circular storage room, one of my favorite designs, honestly. Now, the only problem that I would say that I had with this storage room was, again, expansion. Expansion is a common issue here. This room would be pretty tricky to expand. If I wanted to expand this, I would have to either go up or down, or maybe even just make a separate storage building entirely, just like this one. Another problem could be things like crafting and smelting, something that a lot of the times you're gonna wanna have in your storage building. So I have crafting tables in all of the corners, so maybe that's not a problem, but smelting, no furnaces in sight anywhere, and I don't think... Oh, I did hide them in there. Oh, that was so smart of me. Oh, that was so smart of me. Never mind. Yeah, so in short, the storage building design, the circle, it was pretty functional, and I really, really like this storage room. This is definitely something that we're going to want to try and live up to, but on a larger scale, because, of course, there are a whole lot more blocks now. I mean, talk about 1.14, 1.15, and then 1.16. Yeah, those were all pretty, but well, other than 1.15. 1.14, 1.16, big updates, lots of blocks. So, cool design, but would need to be bigger. A whole lot bigger. Ha, finally, you already know where this place is. Guide to Season 2. In this world, I built probably my favorite and, in my opinion, my best storage building ever. And it was in the middle of everything. It was really, really easy to access, which is another big thing that you're going to want to consider when building your storage building. When you're building your storage building, you want it to be in an accessible, easy to reach place. Don't put your storage building way off in some far corner of your world. Put it where you are working. But this storage building was basically the last one, unlike Steroids. This building was big. It had all of the storage that I would kind of ever need. So in this room, it was a giant circle, and I had like a bunch of things. If I needed wood, I could go right over here and grab it. If I needed some like dirt or something, right over there. Yeah, everything was right around this thing. And then I expanded the room back here later on in the series, and then even more down here later on. I never ended up using this bit, but it's a lot of storage, like way more storage than I would probably ever need. This room is basically like perfect. Design, check, it's really cool looking. Organization, perfect, everything is organized. I mean, we have nether stuff here, then we have wood, then we have like plants and mob drops. Yeah, it's organized. And then function, definitely, absolutely perfect. So basically, we need to live up to this storage building, and that is going to be a hard task, but I think we could definitely do it. We'll have to come up with a really cool design, but it could be done. When setting up a storage building nowadays, you have three main options when it comes to actually storing your blocks. You have chests, you have trap chests, but come on, seriously, why are you gonna use trap chests? They're more expensive, don't use them. So use chests or maybe use barrels. Now, you're definitely gonna wanna keep in mind labels. You probably want your storage room to be organized and easy to use, which means you want your chests to kind of be labeled in some way so you can figure out what is in what. That means probably item frames. Now, when it comes to chest placement in your storage room, you have really two different options. You could go long ways like that and put the frame right on the chest, or you could go like this, and then if you wanted to, you could put the frame on the chest, but that kind of makes it a little bit more challenging to reach your chest, especially if your chests are like all stacked up. Yeah, you're gonna have to aim to a very specific spot on your chest, which for me, when recording, definitely not an option. I have to be way too accurate, and yeah, I'm just kind of not the best at that. So instead, here's what I would recommend. If you're going this route, you could go ahead and put an upside-down staircase above your chest, and then put the frame right on the staircase, and then boom, you can open the chest just like that. That would work. Barrels are also a really good option when it comes to storage, but the only problem here, you don't have a double barrel. So if you're gonna do storage in a barrel, probably store something inside of the barrel that you're not gonna really have a lot of, like maybe like lily pads or something like that. Otherwise, you're gonna need to put two barrels, and then if you're putting two barrels, you have two separate containers, and you might as well just use a single double chest. Another thing to consider and remember when building a storage building, smelting and crafting. Definitely crafting, probably smelting as well. It would be a pretty smart idea to try and incorporate both of these types of blocks and maybe the other options too, like grindstones and such, into your storage building. All right, so let's talk about our storage building design. We've done circle storage buildings kind of a lot, which means this time I'm gonna try and switch it up. It pains me to say this, but I don't think we're gonna do a circle storage building. I think we're gonna try and do a bit of a square or a rectangular storage building, and I think I want my chest this time to be sitting out on top of each other just like this. And then when it comes to the frames, this is how we'll do it. We'll do frames down this row right there, just like that, and then frames over here down this row, just like that. This will be very easy to keep things organized. I'm thinking a tall storage building too, maybe something like 5 chests tall. So that's 4 right there, and then 5 right here. If we go any higher, it might start to get a little bit tricky to reach, so 5. A 5 is probably good. That'll be a gigantic, massive wall of storage chests. In fact, looking at it right now, we might even be able to trim things down and go 4. I'm not too sure. But anyways, we have something like that. Now, in this world, you already know what has been my favorite wood. We want to put some depth on these storage walls, so I'm thinking maybe like dark oak kind of popping out, and we'll have sections of 1, 2, 3, 4 long. So just like that, and then either 4 or 5 tall. Not too sure quite yet. So we'll have something like that. Now, the storage building itself, what are we going to do with it on, say, the outside? Well, I think here that I want this storage building to be some sort of gigantic almost basically like a cathedral type thing. I think that would be so, so cool. So here's what I'm maybe thinking. We go up with like stone. This is going to be a really, really gray build, which guess what? We have a lot of now. We have a lot of stone because we did that whole iron cave thing. It all comes to light now. It all makes sense. It all adds up. I did that iron cave build to get a bunch of stone for this build. So I'm thinking big windows like that, but maybe what we want to do is make this even thicker, which is kind of a bummer. It's gonna mean a little bit more blocks, but make it a little bit thicker so we can put something in here so we can't just see the chest, because otherwise we could do like walls or something. Definitely not that wall. We could do walls in here, but we're gonna have a problem at the top because I wanna do staircases to make the cool little arch. So yeah, we'll definitely have to pop this out a little bit. Okay, so maybe we pop it out like that, and then we could use maybe like blackstone or black concrete in here to kind of make it look like it's really, really deep and dark and, you know, actually like a room inside, something like that. That could be cool. Another option, glass. We could actually put windows and have the chest be seen, which might also be kind of cool. So, on the side of the build, this is what I'm thinking, though. A bunch of tall sections like this, and tall is definitely the theme here. We want this build to be tall, kind of going down like that, and then up top, we'll do something with maybe more stone, maybe like staircases or something, I don't know. We'll try and blend it out somehow, make it look good. Then, on the top, this is what I'm thinking. We'll have this basically go diagonal up, maybe to there or something, or maybe like three layers. Three is pretty good. Then on the top, we're gonna need some type of wood staircase, I think. Maybe spruce. I'm not too sure. This is really just a rough draft right now. When designing a storage building, especially if it's gonna be a big storage building like this one, I highly recommend doing this. Jump over to a creative world, place things down, check it out, take a look at it. It's a whole lot easier to mess with things on a large scale in a creative world than it is in a survival world. So maybe we have something that kind of looks like that, but this is going to be a little weird, so we can come in here with slabs to make that, you know, kind of stick up a little bit more. That could be cool. So that'll get us over to about here, where we have this wall thing going on. Then, I think what we're going to want to do, maybe, is try and pop it straight up a little bit more. So this is going to be definitely a tall build. This is going to be like the main part of our world. It'll be kind of a mega build, honestly. So we'll pop that up a little bit more. Then we can come in here and frame that in and maybe do some windows up top. And then finally, we'll have our top roof, which will basically be the same exact thing. I'm thinking a pretty standard roof line on this thing, 45 degree angle, so we can go nice and tall. Now, speaking of tall, the front side is gonna be a really, really tall, like flat build, but that's okay. We can definitely work with it. So I'm thinking that we could probably use, even more stone, and definitely when we have flat sections of stone, we're gonna wanna come in here with something like cobblestone and detail the thing like crazy, like mix it in here, get a little block variation going on, you know, that type of thing. That will definitely help the build look better. Now, how long will this build be? Well, I'm thinking we have one section there, then we have a second section, and then maybe even a third section. I think three sections would be really good. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so yeah, this is gonna be a big build. And then what I'm thinking is maybe in the middle sections in here, we could actually even save room for like a hallway going this way in case we want to maybe, just maybe, make this part of like a bigger castle-y build later on, which could be really, really cool. But for now, we'll basically have like a doorway on this side, a doorway on the other side, and then maybe a doorway on that back side as well. Now, this side, it's gonna be like the front side, the smaller side. I'm thinking a gigantic window or two in here, which would be really cool. This will be looking out at the lake. It'll be great. Then, because this build is going to be so tall, we do something in here. I don't know if it's that, but we do something. And then we have a top balcony layer where we can walk around up here. It might even end up being higher up. I don't know. But we have like a top balcony where we could do like even more storage chests for like singular smaller things, like maybe enchanted books, lily pads, you know, things that I'm not going to have like a whole lot of. So maybe even more chests up top, just like a row sitting on the floor. That could be pretty cool. All right, so now we have a model, a template that's a whole lot more complete. I have been absolutely busy. I got a little bit of inspiration from Google Images. So check out the build now. Now, of course, right here, you can see a lot of plain blocks and a lot of also missing blocks. When planning out a build in a creative world, you don't have to build the whole build. If you're a fairly confident builder, I would say I am, then you can finish parts of the build and then piece it all together in survival mode. Another big reason you wouldn't want to do your entire you're building a creative world as well, then it's going to be less exciting when you actually get it built in the normal survival world. So here we go. This is what I have. First off, the roof. I'm trying to decide spruce or dark oak. I'm really, really leaning towards dark oak. I think it's going to look a whole lot more cathedral-esque because that is kind of what I'm going for, by the way, at this point. But yeah, so probably dark oak instead of spruce. And then lots and lots of these arches and these spikes here. I want this build to look like, I guess, Victorian-y, medieval, I don't know, like evil looking. So these big spikes would be really, really cool. And then if I really wanted to, which I could definitely afford to, I could actually come in here and make some of these get even more thin and then do iron bars up here, which looks a whole lot more sharp and pointy too. Like from a distance, this build is gonna look really, really sweet. Now, let's talk about this down here, block variation. Definitely gonna need to come in here with like mossy cracked cobblestone or stone brick, excuse me. And then maybe in here, I'm thinking maybe cobblestone, probably andesite instead though. See, if I came in here with andesite, I'd get the variation that I want, which would look good. If I came in here with cobblestone, it would look a little bit more shocking. Anyways though, these arches, I decided to make them a little bit wider. I feel like that looks a little bit more grand. We'll come in here with probably black concrete. That would look really, really good, and just fill these in all the way so it looks really, really dark and deep and cool looking. I think that'll look nice. And we'll have five of those segments. So we have one right here, which actually is a little too short. I'll have to move that down. And then we have another one and another one. That should be perfect. On the higher up part of the build, I decided to keep the roof fully boxed in. That's kind of a whole lot more sturdy and cathedral-y looking, and then I did the same thing up top. Now remember, up top, the roof is going to be identical, so just lots and lots of staircases. It's going to be expensive. Then, on the front, we have the big, grand window. Now, over here, I tried to do a little bit of detailing, get a little bit cool, and then I'm thinking maybe on the front, we could do staircases right there to make that a whole lot more thick looking, and then the glass will actually sit back here, like it'll be in there, probably glass panes, but maybe even glass solid blocks. I'm not too sure quite yet. So looking at the front of the build, we'll have symmetry. I am thinking about keeping a middle divider in there, by the way. I think that would look nice in there, but yeah, symmetry. We'll have this over there on that side, same thing on the other side, which will be cool. Now inside of the build, we have a section of a lot of chests, then a section of a lot of chests, then we have a section of a little chest right there. That's gonna be 50 chests total. That means in total on the first floor of the storage building, we'll have 100 storage chests. Then we have a way in and out over here that I'll have to configure somehow. This is gonna move down. I don't know how it's gonna end up looking in here to like get out, but we're gonna have to just kind of work with it and do our best here. But I would like to have a side exit on the other side, and then an exit on this wall over here. I'm not too sure what I'm gonna do over here, but I am thinking maybe two big towers. So big tower on that side, big tower on the other side. Not too sure quite yet, but that's kind of what I'm thinking. Maybe like, kind of like the Notre Dame. That would be cool. Now, one final thing that I would like to talk about when it comes to storage rooms. So I said 100 chests on floor one. So when you're doing a storage building, you could definitely do multiple floors, but keep in mind that staircases, they're kind of annoying and tedious. So on your main floor, you're gonna wanna put all of the things that you use a lot. So things like dirt, wood, cobblestone, you know, building blocks. Then on the second floor, if you're going the second floor route, of course, you'll put things that are less used. So you don't have to go up the staircase constantly and then back down and then back up. Yeah, that would get really, really annoying. Now, let's talk about the second floor really quick. I don't know how it's gonna be. I know where it's gonna go, which is gonna be above these chests. And I know that I want the second floor to stay pretty open. So if I do a second floor, I was thinking that I could start with probably some blocks or even just staircases right there, and then it won't go out anymore. I want this to stay big and open. So we could have a second floor in here, and then we could literally do the same exact thing that we did down low. We could do chest, we could do chest, we could do chest. Maybe we keep it like a little bit shorter because we'll have a window in here somehow. So yeah, even more chests in here, just all next to each other. We'll have room for item frames on them. It'll look cool. Doing things like this will give us tons and tons of room for our storage building. Storage will never be a problem again in this world. Then for the way up, spiral staircase or bubble column. Not too sure. Either would be really, really good. Now let's talk about size and then let's slide over to the actual world. So it's a good idea to mark things out with wool or just other blocks that are different colors, like maybe concrete or really literally anything. 36 blocks down that way or so, and then 28 blocks or so this way. I went a little past, so when I go over to the other world to clear things out in a second, I have an area that is definitely big enough for the entire build, because this is actually It's going to be a gigantic build. Maybe the biggest build that I've ever built and detailed and made look really good. But here we go. Final look at the build. This is basically what we're going to try and build in the next episode. And then the episode after that, we'll be doing even more. By the way, the interior, I do have an idea too. I'm thinking large black and white checkered flooring. So like there's a section, you know, black and white. I think that would look really, really cool and fancy. And it'll just be flat. We'll have like a maybe a chandelier hanging. Yeah, that's gonna look pretty cool. So when designing a storage room, keep in mind the design. What do you want it to look like a castle or what? Organization. Remember, you're going to want to put like things near each other. So dirt and sand, probably next to dirt and sand, cobblestone and andesite. Yeah, all next to each other. And then finally, function. Remember that this is a storage building. You want your things to be actually, you know, able to pick up and put away. So maybe a storage tower isn't the best idea. Spreading things out on one floor is usually a whole lot better. Your storage building should also be near, of course, where you're building and using the blocks that you're actually storing. Oh boy, 36 by 28. I didn't realize the build was gonna be that big. So how far can we go back? We can go back probably all the way till probably about this area over here. So let's say for now, this is gonna be the back of my 28 blocks. That's gonna go all the way probably over to the water. Yeah, I might have to maybe it won't. We have a lot of land. I might have to readjust things though, but right there and then back. Now, in between episodes, I have a lot of work to do. When we come back next episode, we will have a large, cleared out, flat area somewhere in here. I'm gonna mess around off camera and make sure it's gonna work. I don't want it to be right against the water. I think that would look weird. I want room for like builds, smaller builds in front of the big storage building. So yeah, I'm gonna have to mess around with the thing and try and make it work. I'll clear out the area, I'll level the area. Next episode, we'll be able to do the whole mega build itself. It's gonna be pretty sweet. Hopefully we'll have a detailed, gigantic storage building by the end of the next episode sitting over there, which will be really, really cool. But I think it is now, finally, time for the comment of the day. So today's comment of the day, Waddles, why are you always hating on the parrot, Mason S? So you actually have it twisted. Off camera, the parrot is actually hating on me, and all that I'm doing is, you know, kind of getting revenge on the parrot. The parrot is evil. Remember, it tried to exterminate the bees, and off camera, it tries to do very extreme things, we will say. So really, it's not me, it's the parrot. But that's gonna do it for this episode of the Minecraft Guide. One final thing though, saw a couple questions about the lack of the comment of the day in the world tour. I decided to just do the tour, save the comment of the day for the actual episode. So yep, that's where that was last episode. Sorry to disappoint. But like I said, when I come back next episode, behind me will be a gigantic deforested area. Today, I'd like to send a big shout out to my patrons, Archangel and Ground Crazy Mate. Thank you so much for the support. Until next time, smash like, subscribe. I'll see you in the next video. Video elites, goodbye.